Pete Mueller here, National Wild Turkey Federation. We have turkey season already opened up in a few states, and it's about ready to get even a little bit more busy across the country. So we're testing out a few broadheads for all those bow hunters out there hoping to take a turkey with their bow this year. We're going to be shooting on a Bowtech Realm. We are going to be using Bloodsport Prosecutor arrows. And first firing a couple arrows with some field tips on them just to show off accuracy, and then we're going to end up comparing everything after that with all the broadheads that we shoot. So we've established our baseline group with field points and shooting our arrows, so now we're going to run through starting with Bloodsport's Gravedigger, working our way down the entire line. We're going to be just shooting again at that bullseye, trying to see how far off or how close they end up to that same spot where those field points were hitting. We'll also be doing a little bit of checking for other things like penetration into that high density foam target. So we've tested accuracy, we've measured penetration into the block target, but now we get to one of the more fun parts, and that's where we show how this broadhead would potentially perform on a turkey. And that's where we're gonna blow these broadheads through some oven roasted chickens, and we're gonna see whether or not they open up. We're gonna see how durable these broadheads are. If they smack a bone, are they gonna break? Again, we're gonna start at the top, grave diggers, run all the way down, and go from there. Looking at our target here, man, it's just littered with chicken. I mean, just all kinds of stuff. And last ones that we shot was the Rage 4 blade. I mean, you can just see that, just that absolutely massive cut on that block target. But taking a look at these chickens here, again, we're just kind of checking to see if they did what they were supposed to. I mean, that right there is a pretty massive cut on the entry. The exit wound, I mean, that absolutely sliced through the thigh bone and part of the drumstick right here. So no problem at all. No problem at all with sharpness on that guy. I mean, that right there will definitely leave a good hole. We have the Muzzy 1 fixed blade. Again, that was a single piece. Just taking a look, you can see that typical 3-blade. That's the exit right there. Our entry on the other side. Again, pretty good size hole, but exactly what you expect from a fixed blade. I mean, we've got deep cut into the thigh on this side, went all the way through the breast. Can't tell if the back got broken at all, but again, just a nice, big, clean, triangular wound there. So no issues on that one. This was our switchblade from Rocky Mountain Broadheads. That right there, pretty impressive. I mean, I'd say at least just looking at initial damage, you have a wing cut in half. I don't know if you can see this, but the back inside actually has a pretty good sever line on it. And just a massive hole that you can pretty much see all the way through. This was our entry and then our exit. Another mechanical here was our dead ringer hatchet. Now, this bird actually feels like it's still a little bit frozen, but if you look here, you have a nice clean line. Again, that's a 2-blade. So nice clean line. It looked like it opened up just fine. No problems there. Again, here's our entry on this side. But that exit, nice clean cut. And again, that's a pretty good cut there on the exit side, so you're probably looking at about a 2-inch cut. This was another one of our fixed blades. This was the PSD from Dead Ringer. Again, you can tell easily there that you've got good cut from your main 2 blades and then your bleeders. This one also feels like it's a little bit still frozen. Here's our exit. obviously same size in as it is going out. That's the way fixed blades work. But no issues there. I didn't see any issue at all with damage to the broadhead. Things still look nice and sharp. Doesn't look like we hit any bone on that one to really test things out for durability wise though. This was the full cut X. Hit it just a little bit far back, but again, you can see that typical plus sign from a four blade fixed. In and out. Again, I don't think that we hit any solid bone to test things out, but again, no issues there. This Ramcat cage ripper hit this chicken so hard that it actually knocked the entire thing off the box. That right there looks like our exit. I think that's our exit. Here's our entry. This bird still feels like it's a little bit frozen, so I think that contributed a little bit to what we had happen. But still, I mean, there's a solid cut all the way through. I'd be interested to see when we open it up whether or not it ended up cutting through part of that backbone right there in the middle of the bird. But I would definitely say that being frozen helped out on that one a little bit, but again, no issue with it cutting. Obviously, it looks like it opened up just fine. And then finally, this was our Bloodsport Grave Digger. This one right here, you can see entry point. So again, that's your four blade on the exit. This is a mechanical, so it does look like we did have deployment, cut through part of the wing, and did end up cutting all the way through part of that breast as it went through. So again, no issues with opening on that mechanical. All right, we've had a chance to run these broadheads through all of our tests out here today. We shot them for accuracy, did penetration testing, took some measurements on that, gave observations straight out of the box. It's available in the description in the video below. And then you saw us shoot them through these chickens, and mechanicals performed the way that they were supposed to, opening up. So I think it's pretty safe to say that, you know, take a look at the full list of broadheads that we have, but if you happen to be bow hunting this spring and a gobbler comes strutting into your decoys, looks like pretty much any one of these would be able to help you bag that bird.